and welcome to the Everett Silver Show. We have exciting guests as we do every week. And so I want to thank you so much for tuning in. And I'm always bringing it to you. So thanks so much for staying in tune with us. Stay connected. You're watching the Everett
Silver Show. Diaper delivery for Miss Veronica.
Hey.
We'd like to keep our clinic nice, clean, and neat. Veronica just isn't letting that happen. So poop patrol to the rescue. People are kind of starting to talk around town about you and me.
We're having another baby. Oh, that's awesome.
Here's some women ones.
Yeah. Well,
I mean, there's some rumors about you now.
I know. Well, those probably aren't wrong. But I don't think I'm a small. I really thought once I finally got Charlie and Chase house trained, I mean potty trained, life was going to be good. We need a tail hole.
I never thought I'd be buying diapers again, but Aaron loves Veronica with her whole heart. And I'll do whatever it takes to keep her here.
I think she's got more junk in the trunk.
We gotta try these ones made for women.
Here's hoping. I mean, it's kind of a sporty cut here, like a 1980s bathing suit.
I think that might work.
Yeah, she is not a baby diaper size. They've got a big waist. I mean, they have a rumen, for goodness sakes. Her four stomachs are slightly large.
She's always a woman to me.
Oh, honey.
All right, V. See how this works.
Oh, this is a good girl. Yeah, she's a good baby.
Hey, Everett.
Hi, Everett.
Well, I want to say hello to Doctors Ben and Aaron Schrader, guys. Every time I got the veterinarian sweethearts of America, guys. Welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you. I love that introduction.
Sweethearts of America. We'll take it.
But listen, guys, I know, and I guess, Aaron, I start with you because when I look at some of the things and the, you know, the trailers that I have, you know, my first question got to ask you, what made you fall in love with animals the way you care for them so much?
You know, that is a great question. I just was born this way, I think. Even when I look back, my mom saved all my little things. You know, what do you want to be when you grow up? And every one of them has a veterinarian written on it. I mean, some unique spellings, of course. But that's what I've always wanted to do. When I would play Barbies, I would actually set up the Barbie, you know, whatever, dream house, pool house, whatever it was. And I would bring in like salamanders and newts and make a habitat. So
she still does that, by the way.
That was very normal. But I don't know. I guess it was in my stars.
Aaron, it sounds like Ben is telling on you. So Ben, with that being said, listen, yeah, I know taking care of animals is the family business. So Ben, did you think that this is what you wanted your family to do, buddy?
I really did. I went to vet school, you know, with a dad who didn't really push me to be a vet, but he said, you know, if you want to, it's a great way to spend your life. And it really is. But that being said, I have four other brothers and sisters that all became, you know, something in the medical field, and they enjoy what they do too. Mm-hmm. So if you love what you do, I think you're going to have a great life. And Aaron and I really do love what we do.
And I tell you, it seems like that's where success comes when you're at the heart of it. Now, talking about it, Heartland Docs DMV returns all new episode. You guys got some interesting things that are going on because this season, you know, it's going to be full of treats. But you got some situations there with the animals. You got a horse with a catastrophic leg injury, eagle, you know, that's on the brink of heat stroke. So with that being said, talk about the different. I got tickled when I saw the one where you had to get a pamper for talk about that.
Well, you know,
everybody thought we were having more kids.
No,
but we are.
Yep, that ship sailed. We had a goat come in that needed a home, and I said yes. It's kind of like when I met you. I was like, you look like you need a home. And I've had to buy campers for you yet. Veronica was just this sweet little pygmy goat, and she just needed a little TLC. But goats are pooping machines, and it was really tough. You know, we have one of our dogs here right now, but any pets around the clinic, if she would poop, we're always trying to eat goat's poop. It was just a mess. So Ben had to go on a little shopping trip for some diapers for the goat. And we were out of diapers. Like, our kids are 17 and 15. And so it's been a while since I pampered anything, but let alone a fuzzy goat.
We figured it out.
We got her done.
And that being said, like you said, you never know when the phone rings, you know, what species is going to, you know, be the next to treat, how far we're going to have to travel to go get there. It's quite a job, and we really, really do love every part of it.
And then, Ben, I was thinking about when you said that, how much does the community and the love for the community that you have really depend on you guys when they're a little, you know, whether it's a furry friend or something going on, that they really, you know, count on you guys to take care of them?
It's pretty fitting. We live in the town that's named Hardington, and there's a lot of heart here. Yeah, a lot of heart. With people calling in and Aaron and I, you know, coming at any beckoning, you know, it could be midnight or 2 a.m. We go pull a calf or, you know, just whatever. These people around here rely on us to do our job and to do it efficiently and professionally. And hopefully we do that to the best of our ability.
But they also become family. You know, when you are that close to someone working on their livestock or their pet, you know, in rough times and bad weather, you get a connection with just being together and going through that together. And so we really, you know, feel like our community is our family. It's an extension. Family.
So I got. Let me just end with this, guys. I got to tell you, I saw something in the press release, and I'm gonna end with this: is that it is so fitting to say this, but your dedication that requires from you guys proves that not only the only one massive thing from the vets part of it, but it also shows you guys' heart. And I want to tell everybody again: you got to catch the new season Heartland Docs DMV premieres January 30th, which is tomorrow night, guys, at 10 p.m. And so make sure that you do it. Tune into it. Again, Doctors Aaron and Ben Schrader, thank you guys so much for doing the show.
Thank you so much.
Watch us on Nat Geo Wild.
Thank you.
There you go. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye-bye.
Well, guys, thanks so much for tuning into the Everett Silver Show. Stay tuned. Don't turn that dial because we got more exciting guests right here on the Everett Silver Show. Be back.
Our high jumper Wesley is about to leap into action. But before he does, I'm interested. Snoop, do you have any hops?
I got to do this, bro.
Now I gotta try that.
Oh, no.
No.
You just jumped right up.
Vertical.
No. Oh, my God. Oh, God.
Bert, what's going on, man?
How you doing, Everett?
Doing great, man. I'm telling you, folks, I got the wonderful privilege of talking to the host, the master ceremony of TV's biggest new competition show, Go Big Show. Bert Kreischer is here with us. And Bert, man, you got a fun job, man, because I'm telling you, how do you keep a straight face being a comedian, man? Most of the stream talent you got host.
Let me tell you something, Everett. I feel like I'm stealing money from TBS. It is the funnest job you could ever imagine. First of all, I'm a wrestling fan, so I get to hang out with Cody Rhodes, who is wrestling royalty. So every question I had that I wanted to ask when I was 12 years old about wrestling, I now get to ask about the Von Erich brothers, you name it, anything wrestling I get to know. Now, secondly, Rosario Dawson and Jennifer Nettles are amazing. Jennifer Nettles has the voice of an angel. You can just say to her, hey, that song Hallelujah from Shrek, could you sing that? She does it and your ears melt. Rosario Dawson is probably one of the most kind-hearted, sweetest persons who had Cory Booker on set with us. So anytime you wanted to talk politics, you could pull Cory Booker aside and talk politics. Then you get to work with Snoop Dogg. Now, Snoop Dogg, in my opinion, can do no wrong. That man was made by the angels sent down here from the heavens, and he is a blast.
Man, you know, I got tickled when I saw one of the pilots, man, where Snoop goes up to the he jumps on the stage and you says, man, I got to top that, man. And when you try, it was so hilarious, man.
Yeah, I know. It was horrible. I almost blew out both my patellas on that.
Now, but
anytime there was any physical stunt, Snoop Dogg was up there immediately. A trick shot, you name it, Snoop wanted a piece of it.
Well, listen, Bert, how fun is it, man, and creative, I should say, that you're doing all this in front of a drive-in audience, man, you know, making College Center in Georgia. What is that like, man? Because I know even when I say that, because you have a tour, man, that's going around the country, man. I think it's Hot Summer Nights Tour, and you're doing the same thing in front of a drive-in audience. How is that, man, today's world?
I'll tell you what, it's a lot of fun. We did the drive-in tour. We did about four runs of it. And when we started doing the Go Big Show, I said to them, you know, I've been doing these drive-in movie theaters. If you want, I can just put out a thing on social media, let my fans know. If we put up a big screen, they can watch the show live. And it was a perfect synergy of what I was doing and what we were going to do. And I don't know if you've been to a drive-in movie theater. I've been to every drive-in movie theater in the country. First of all, they're absolutely gorgeous. I think I did one just outside Raleigh, to be honest with you. Absolutely gorgeous. And it's a fun event. Everyone gets out socially distant in the back of their car, sets up some camping, has a cold beer, maybe builds a little space heater plugged into the truck, blankets on. I'm telling you, we ended up using the drive-in movie theater we did for the Go Big Show because we were in a bubble. We ended up throwing Jurassic Park on it, and the whole crew sat out on one of our days off and watched Jurassic Park as a thunderstorm rolled in. It was the best amazing thing.
Well, Bert, I got to tell you, man, I'm definitely a drive-in guy, man, because I remember when it came out, and I think there are talks of people talking about doing it again, man. We have a few here. You mentioned Raleigh that, you know, some people are starting to do something with. But Bert, I tell you, man, you've been doing it. I've been following you for some time, man. You got the earlier shows, Secret Time, The Machine, that you currently can just stream folks globally on Netflix. And then, Bert, what other last-minute things you want to say? Because I know the show airs Thursday nights, Go Big Show, Thursday nights at 9 p.m. on TBS. What are last-minute things, Bert, you want to say, man?
I want to tell you to watch tonight. It's going to blow your mind. You're going to see some honky-tonk thrills. You're going to see some slacklining Speedos, and you will see Leonid the Magnificent, and he will blow your mind. Right.
And, Bert, do you have anything that sometimes you just stuck? Because I saw one, man, the guy was like, I thought he was going to stab the girl, and then one is going like eating snakes. You have a surprise?
I was shocked every morning. I was like, wait, nine alligators? What are we doing today? Monster. Wait, why is this place filled with dirt? Who brought a bull? What, is it a monster truck? Rattlesnakes? Every day, I was like, first of all, I don't feel safe for me. But I don't see how this guy's coming out on the other end.
I love it, man. My man, Bert Kreischer, has been with us, the host of, I'm telling you, Go Big Show. You got to catch it tonight, folks, 9 p.m. on TBS. Bert, well, what a pleasure to have you, man.
Have a great day, Everett. Thank you so much for having me, man. I appreciate it.
Hey, you're welcome, buddy. Good success to you, man.
Thank you. You too.
More guests coming your way. Don't touch that dial. Be back in a moment.
Folks, my guest is with us. Startling results from the New Health Trends survey revealed that women are disproportionately experiencing the physical, financial, as well as mental impact from the pandemic. And the survey also finds that COVID-19 exposure is leading Americans to avoid preventive and also the routine care, and even preventing people who need a COVID test from getting one. I have Dr. Harvey Kaufman here, Senior Medical Director, also head of the Health Trends Research Program, you know, for Request Diagnostics, and he's joining us with the new survey results to talk about why it's so important for Americans to get back to care. So with that being said, Dr. Kaufman, women are disproportionately, I guess, bearing the negative impact from the pandemic. Can you tell us what the survey has revealed?
Yes, Everett. So let me just tell you a little about the survey itself. We were guided by our mission to empower people to take actions to improve their health. So we collaborated with the Harris Poll to survey more than 2,000 Americans across the spectrum, across the country, to better understand, to dig deeper into the real issues that people are facing in healthcare during this catastrophic pandemic. And one of the findings was that women are bearing the brunt more than men. They feel more stress, They're more likely to experience mental and physical health issues, and they're more likely to bear the financial hardship of the pandemic. In part because women have been more affected, but in addition, women tend to be the caregivers in their nuclear and extended families, and as such, they tend to take care of others first and neglect their own care to their own peril and to those that are loved by them.
Now, Dr. Carvin, talk about the fear of exposure to COVID-19 is leading many Americans to delay their routine or even preventive care. What is the potential impact, on these delays?
So, in our survey, 60% of Americans said that they canceled or delayed an in-person medical visit during the pandemic. And the consequence of that is that many people will have disease that will progress. Organ damage will occur. And so as disease progresses to a more advanced stage, one might need more aggressive therapy that's going to be less effective. And yes, some people will progress to the stage and will die as a consequence of delay in seeking medical care.
And then, Dr. Kaufman, who's most at risk at delaying care?
It covers the spectrum, Everett. So young children in our survey were affected just as older people were. In the Quest Diagnostics data, we saw gaps in care in lead testing. We saw gaps in care in testing for chlamydia and gonorrhea of sexually active young women. And for older adults, there's gaps in care for testing and screening for hypertension and diabetes, chronic kidney disease. And if we think about cancer, there's gaps in care for cervical cancer, prostate cancer, mammographies for breast cancer, colorectal cancer screenings, and there's a gap in care in vaccinations. And by delaying care, people will have more vulnerable to disease, and they'll also advance to a point where they'll need more aggressive therapy and may have worse outcomes.
Now, Dr. Kaufman, talk about after 9 months, I guess, dealing with this COVID-19, what lessons have we learned and what do Americans need to know?
Everett, great question. Always in terms of reflecting back on what we've learned. And we've learned so much about the virus itself, and we've learned so much about COVID-19, the disease and treatments that are effective. And we've developed a vaccine at unprecedented speed that's extremely effective and figured out how to manufacture and distribute that. And that's the science and medicine. And what we need to, in this survey, is look at what's in our hearts and what's in our minds. And what's in our hearts and minds is fear, anxiety, concern. We need to address those issues too with facts and reassurance that seeking health care is safe. So we've created a website, questdiagnostics.com/peaceofmind, which has great information. No one's been infected getting tested, and yet so many Americans are fearful of getting tested. And so we need to get people who think they need a test to get tested. In our survey, 74% of Americans delayed or didn't get it, skipped a test altogether. So they're putting themselves at risk, their communities, and if they don't get tested and diagnosed quickly and wait until they're in respiratory distress, they'll be in an intensive care unit, more aggressive therapy with worse outcomes.
Dr. Kaufman, that's an astounding number, 74%. Man, that is really, that's an astounding. Folks, I want to make sure you go to Quest Diagnostics/peaceofmind again for further information. I want to thank my very special guest, Dr. Harvey Kaufman, Senior Medical Director and Health, Head of Health at Trends Research Program for Quest Diagnostics. So much vital information. Thanks, Dr. Kaufman, for doing the show.
Everett, thank you very much.
You're welcome, sir. Bye-bye.
More guests coming your way. Don't touch that dial. Be back in a moment.
Hey, Dr. Richardson, and also Laura, thanks for doing the show. Well, folks, my guest is with us. There's a hidden impact of COVID-19 that Americans may be failing to understand, and thousands of cancers, you know, may be getting detected, I should say, early when treatment is most effective. Cancer isn't waiting. It's not waiting for people to do or to see doctor, but to get their screenings or to maintain their checkups. So joining us to talk about, the importance of health concern is Dr. Lisa Richardson, from the CDC's Division of Cancer Prevention and Control. Also joining her is Laura McElroth, is with us, Senior Vice President of Prevention and Early Detection at the American Cancer Society. So I want to welcome you both. And Dr. Richardson, I start with you. What have you seen, the most drastic and potentially dangerous hidden aspects of COVID-19?
Well, Everett, thanks for having us today. And you know what we've noticed at CDC is that people are not coming in for their cancer screenings. At the beginning of the pandemic, it dropped 90-95%, and that's very concerning because we know that cancers are going undiagnosed, undetected. They're growing and getting larger, and they're going to be harder to treat moving forward. The ultimate, you know, outcome that we're afraid of is that more people will die of cancer when it's not necessary. And so we really are here today to talk with people about how important it is to continue their well care, including cancer screenings.
Now, well, Laura, what are some of the biggest concerns right now for the providers who, I guess, deliver some health care?
Yeah, thanks again for having us. Great question. You know, one of the biggest concerns is that we're worried that people are waiting and not coming in when they have symptoms. So we want people to call their doctor if they're having any symptoms, and then also remember their self-care, like Dr. Richardson said, that cancer screening is a really important part of our annual preventive care, and that now is the time to remember cancer screening and to remember to take care of your body and be aware of any screenings that you may be due for. Talk to your healthcare provider about when and how often you should be screened. And then most important, in addition to that, is to pay attention to any new symptoms. If you're having any ongoing weight loss or pain or anything that's not going away that's new and different for you, be sure to talk to your healthcare provider about that too.
Now, Dr. Richardson, when it comes to health screening or cancer screening, I should say, what should people talk about when they go to the healthcare providers?
Well, first, I would say to deal with the fear that we have, all of us have, around getting COVID if we go out to the doctor. So query them about, you know, what protective measures they have in place, how often they clean, the, you know, protective equipment that they're using. And then you can start talking about when you should start your screening, how often, and then just, you know, to show up to do that and understand that if the proper procedures are in place at your doctor's office or other facilities, you should be fine getting the care that you need.
And then, Laura, any other things that you want to talk about from the healthcare provider side that, you know, you want us to pay attention to?
Yeah, I think, you know, importantly, we want to be sure to remember that the COVID pandemic is having a disproportionate burden on communities and populations of people who are medically underserved. So as providers, we want to be sure that we're reaching out and helping people feel safe to get reengaged in care, either through telemedicine where that's appropriate, but also making sure that patients understand all of the safety measures in place so that it's safe to come back to the clinic for care, to get your screening done, and then to get any new symptoms evaluated that you might be having.
And then Dr. Richardson, lastly, I guess information is, you know, we talk about it, how powerful it is. Trying to find information around COVID-19 or the impact on cancer care, where do we go and what do we do?
So I'd recommend cdc.gov/cancer. Apologies for that, and cdc.gov/coronavirus. There's tons of information there for providers and, you know, regular citizens like us.
Again, I want to thank Dr. Lisa Richardson from CDC's Division of Cancer Prevention and Control, and also Laura McElroth has been with us, Senior Vice President of Prevention and Early Detection there at the American Cancer Society. So much wonderful information. Thanks, guys, so much for doing the show.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Sing, get the song.